What is up, YouTube, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Aga and I make food and fitness content. And today I am just bringing you a very realistic what I eat in a day. I train for a marathon and I weightlift, so I follow a very much of a hybrid training program. And because of that, I need to eat high protein. And I'm also vegetarian, so I make sure that I get all of the protein that I need without consuming any meat or fish. And I just bring you along a lot of recipe inspiration and some motivation as well. So if you like the topic, please feel free to like this video and subscribe to my channel. It really does help me reach more people and get more out there, and I just really, really appreciate that. But without further ado, let's just get into the video because it is my rest day and I do have a lot of recipes to share or a lot of meal inspiration to share. So without any further rambling, let's just get into it. Good morning. I am actually just about to make breakfast. I already had my morning coffee. I already started work because I am working from home today, and I am about to make breakfast because I'm getting really hungry. And we all know the importance of a high protein breakfast lately, and for me, whenever it's the weekend or I'm working from home, it's usually eggs. So let's just make some scrambled eggs because that's what I'm really craving today. Okay, so here I have 3 eggs with this scrambled egg seasoning, and then I have some butter, I have a tomato that I'm just gonna eat raw, I have some green onions, I have some bread that I just defrosted. It's actually nice and soft already, but it was in my freezer. And then I have some feta because lately I have been enjoying adding light feta to my eggs. It also adds a little bit of protein. And by the way, this is 3 eggs. Sometimes I do 2, sometimes I do 3, but these were quite small. So I just decided, okay, let's go ahead and just beat up 3 eggs because 2 would not be enough this time. And there we go, my scrambled eggs with feta, green onions, some tomatoes, and a hefty piece of bread. I know it's just 1 piece, but it's actually quite thick, so it's around 50 grams of bread. And all in all, this has 490 calories and 27 grams of protein, so it's really not bad for a breakfast. I usually like to aim for around 20 to 30 grams of protein for breakfast because it does keep me full, and supposedly it also keeps, you know, blood sugar levels stable, and it's supposed to be good for you. So that's what I do. I mean, I do like to have protein for breakfast anyway because I like to have protein with all of my meals to then hit around 100 to 120 grams per day. So it's actually very essential that I also have some for breakfast regardless of the supposed benefits of a high protein breakfast. But let's just give it a try because I never actually tried the scrambled egg seasoning, so I'm very excited. It's actually very good. It doesn't need much more, and the feta is one of my favorite things to add to scrambled eggs. It's just so delicious. And these tomatoes my parents brought from Poland, and they're so good. It's like my favorite tomatoes ever. That's why I'm able just to have a whole tomato on the side, because they are delicious, and the bread is sourdough, you know, from one of my favorite bakeries. So honestly, this is just the perfect breakfast.
I actually just went grocery shopping and I wanted to show you a very small grocery haul. Very, very small, but it's enough because I have a lot of things. So I got raspberries. That is very typical for me to get raspberries. Raspberries have a ton of fiber and they're also delicious. I got some sweet potatoes, smaller ones that I will roast up and have throughout the week for dinner. I got some skyr yogurt. So this is Greek yogurt. I never get the one that's 0% because I find it absolutely disgusting. So I get a 5% Greek yogurt and it's very, very, very good. Then I got some mozzarella for some caprese salad. I got this cereal, which is a little bit healthier than regular cereal, and this one is delicious. Not all the cereals from this brand are good, but this one specifically, amazing, amazing. I eat it before my runs and just as a snack sometimes. And then I get broccoli that I'm gonna eat today and meal prep, which you will see what I do with that. And then I picked up this frozen meal. This is just a vegan bami goreng, and it looked pretty good. It has a lot of protein, a lot of fiber, and I don't have time to cook lunch today, so I will actually just have that. And the macros and the calories look pretty good. It has around 500 calories and 20 grams of protein, also almost 10 grams of fiber. So I guess I will actually just make that quickly and eat it because I'm honestly quite hungry. Thank you. All right, let's try this thing. It actually smells really good. I definitely picked the wrong pan because everything just stuck to it. I should have just used a non-stick pan. I should have known better, but obviously I didn't know better. So let's just try it. It needs some salt. Let's just salt this a bit. It was not salty at all, which is not something I would expect from a frozen meal. And I don't like my things over salted either. It's just should have had a little bit more. I don't know. Okay, let's try this again. The vegan chicken is actually good in this. Okay, I don't mind it. Okay, the final review is that I don't know if I would buy it again, but I will enjoy it now. Like, it's not like I don't like it, it's just not that I like it enough to purchase it again because it wasn't super cheap, so... Honestly, I don't eat a lot of mock meats because they don't make my stomach feel too great if I eat them over and over. So I usually just have it either as like a frozen meal, like one and done, one meal, 20 grams, 20, 30 grams of protein, I will eat it. But if I'm making something at home, I usually try to avoid it just because I feel better when I eat either like cheeses or tofu, tempeh, beans. It just makes me feel much, much better than mock meat. But that being said, I do like mock meat, so I do enjoy it sometimes. But yeah, let me just go because I am still working. I'm working from home and I definitely need to get back. So I will see you for dinner. I am a little bit hungry, but I am still working. So all I can do is snack a little bit. So I just had more than a half of this pack of raspberries. Raspberries have so much fiber. I checked on my chronometer that I was lacking some fiber. Had some strawberries, problem fixed. But I'm also lacking some protein today. Usually when I take a rest day, I'm just not as hungry, which is quite obvious, but again, I am a little bit snacky, a little bit hungry, so I'm just gonna have this protein bar. It's a smaller protein bar, by the way. My cat is also here, as always. This is a smaller protein bar because sometimes, like the big ones, like the 200 calorie ones, are a little bit too much. This one is like 150 calories and 14 grams of protein, so it's a good snack combined with the raspberries. So we have protein and fiber. Very good snack right there. And then in a couple hours, I'll just make dinner. So I don't need a massive, massive snack. Actually, what I haven't shared with you yet is that I got my ultrahuman ring delivered last week. I cannot do a full review on it yet because it has literally been like 4 days. And it even says that it needs around 2 weeks to fully get to know you and your routines to like be fully adjusted to you. But it came in this cute little package, which I'm keeping to do a full-on review, obviously. So I just unpacked it and I've been wearing it ever since. And I am low-key obsessed with it. Well, not even low-key obsessed with it. I'm like properly obsessed with it. Let me put it up on a screen here so we can just take a look at it together. So first of all, it tells me till when can I have caffeine. So currently I have an hour left. So I should stop consuming caffeine to then get a good night's sleep, which is good because it keeps me in check. It also tracks my period based on the temperature, and it's not an additional fee like it is with Aura. I have not tested it yet fully, so I wouldn't know, but technically it should be able to detect my period based on the temperature, which is really, really cool. It tracks my movement, and I find it to be not very off compared to my Apple Watch. So it looks pretty good. It tracks my stress rhythm, so my stress levels throughout the day, which is super cool actually. And it turns out that I have actually never been relaxed in my life because most of the time I am apparently stressed or stimulated. Well, yesterday I was pretty relaxed, but it also counts the relaxed state during sleep. So then if I actually take a look at the rest of my day, I am rather stressed. Same on Saturday, it actually looks pretty bad. So I definitely need to work on that a little bit, but it's good to know that I have something to work towards. It has the dynamic recovery score, which I'm still not sure what it means. I think it just tracks like how well I slept and how good I'm doing. And then the sleep score, turns out my sleep is not that great, so something to definitely work on. And then another cool thing that it measures a lot of the cardio things because it does measure your heart rate. So it actually can tell me, you know, what VO2 max I have, which turns out mine is actually really good. It's actually superior, which is very funny. I keep telling everybody about it. And also resting heart rate and HRV. HRV is also related to how stressed you are, so mine is actually not great. But yeah, all in all, so far, I really like it. I am excited to wear it for longer because maybe after, I don't know, a month, I can do a full-on review, like a proper sit-down review of this product, because as of right now, like, it's very hard for me to tell. I'm still testing it. I'm still learning about it. I still haven't tried all of the features also of the app. So yeah, please let me know in the comments if you would actually be interested of a full-on review of the ultrahuman ring, because to be honest, even if you're not interested, I will probably do one because I am interested and I really want to do it. And I was watching a bunch of them before I actually made a purchase myself, so I think it would be very useful. But still, please let me know. Also, let me know if you have any random questions about the ring. I'm happy to help out there as well. But yeah, so far so good. Let's see if I like it in a couple weeks though. So I basically prepared everything for dinner. I have 250 grams of pasta measured right here. I have a whole head of broccoli cut up beforehand. This is some nutritional yeast. I have some garlic cloves. And I also cut up the Beyond sausages. I just viciously cut them up. And here I'm already boiling some water. And I put, I don't know if you can see it, but I put my iron fish in there so that everything just has a little bit more iron. And it's quite a great hack actually, because I'm just cooking the water in it. It's very low effort. And I'm gonna take it out and then put the pasta in, and the broccoli and everything is just gonna infuse with a little bit more iron. And then the garlic and the sausage, I'm gonna heat up on a pan, make it nice and crispy, and then combine everything together. And it's gonna be a very delicious and easy dinner that's gonna take me, I think, like 15 minutes. And that is it. The super quick meal is done. And I know what you're thinking. Where is the sauce? And why is my light going on and off the whole time? But it actually is super flavorful without the sauce even. I don't know. I just love it. Sometimes I just don't need sauce. And there's like the oil from the sausage and the olive oil and the garlic. It all kind of comes together and gives flavor to the pasta and the broccoli. And I just love it. And this actually makes three portions. So I'm gonna have one portion now. And then I'm gonna pack up the two other portions for work. And there we go. Dinner for now. And then lunch for the next 2 days for work ready. Honestly, 15 minutes, because all it took is the time that it took to cook pasta. And we have three meals. One of them has 600 calories and 28 grams of protein. So I would say a pretty solid meal, not to mention delicious. And yeah, it provides me everything I need. Also quite a lot of fiber from the broccoli. Protein comes from the sausage, and then also a little bit from the pasta, and then a lot of carbs as well to keep me full throughout the day. I now realize that I talked beforehand that I'm not necessarily eating a lot of mock meats, and then look at me with the Beyond sausage, which we all know that Beyond is not the most nutritious thing you can eat, but it's also very, very good. And sometimes I really like it. It just makes for such an easy meal, and sometimes mock meat is just life-saving when it comes to time. So anyway, let's just try the pasta, although this is not a first taste test because I did already have some from the pan when I was plating it. But okay, let's just take a bite with everything. Cheers. Delicious. Somehow the olive oil and the pasta water makes for like almost a sauce, and it's such a fallback meal for me. You can do it with any mock meat or even tempeh, but I would suggest mock meat because then you don't have to season anything. You can just, you know, put it on a pan, brown it up a little bit, add everything else. If you're using tempeh or tofu, you probably have to do more to it. And this is just so easy, and it makes three portions really, really delicious. But anyway, I think it's time to conclude today's video because it's around 8 p.m. I really need to get some sleep because, you know, ultrahuman told me that I need to sleep more. But yeah, if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, because like I said beforehand, it really does help me reach more people, and I just really, really appreciate that. So thank you once again for watching this video, and I hope I will see you next time. Bye.